Our identity is both a source of strength and a symbol of distinction. While so many divisions have been fueled by identity conflicts, we are fortunate to have members of civil society who embrace and cherish diversity. Our next speaker, Advocate Shaha Basto, is a civil rights lawyer, columnist, academic, and a staunch believer in democracy, federalism, and liberties. His op-ed columns in Dawn and Daily Times highlight narratives on socio-political issues. We are pleased to hear your perspective today, Shahab Saab. Welcome.
Thank you, Adi, Anita, and Ahuja family. I'm really grateful. Urdu mein galaya, Sindhi mein Angrezi. Well, initially I was not really so, I must admit, enthusiastic about this occasion, because I thought it would be another hollow talk shop that we are going to attend. But when I read the topic, I was intrigued. The objective of this conference is to unite and integrate the people of Indus through discussions on social and political conflicts, accepting the differences and bringing together people of diverse cultures living along the Indus River. Now, I must say, it is too ambitious a topic to really encompass in this 10 or 15 minutes address. But I would actually like to focus on the missing links that our speakers have touched upon but really not dwelled upon. I would say that, first of all, we have to admit that we are living in a world which is quintessentially diverse. There is hardly any country in the world which is truly homogeneous. Maybe Mongolia, maybe Japan, some rare countries you may come across. Otherwise, every country has heterogeneity in terms of language, in terms of culture, in terms of ideological, religious, sectarian differences. And I think this is the reality that we have to accept. Unless we accept the diversity and then seek strength in the unity, we cannot move forward. Now, the problem of integration, which is a very ambitious project, I must say, is that the ultimate vehicle to bring about integrity is the modern state. Now, without looking at the nature, function, and the duties or the responsibilities of the modern state, we cannot actually understand or conceive or come up with any solution with regard to the efforts to bring about integration among diverse. I'm not saying conflicting. Now, if you look at the history of the modern state, from the Treaty of Westphalia, 1648, the modern state has developed in fits and starts and stages. The European journey is totally different. Europe has passed through an age of Renaissance, then Enlightenment, then what you call age of reason, and then industrial society, and then followed by the modern welfare nation state, but which actually is not a nation state as such, because they are still in Europe. You will find so many countries that are not really homogeneous. So I see, as Hegel used to say, that history is march of reason. So in Europe, we see the march of reason from one stage to another. It is not that they have not had horrible wars. They have had 100-year war just to settle that who is going to wear the crown of Kingdom of France. They had 30 years war just to settle whether the role of Pope should extend to Germany or not. So they also had their share of revolutions, wars, regicides, fratricides. But somehow or the other, they kept the nation building or nation state building process going on. And ultimately, I think by the late 19th century in Europe, when the Italian unification and the German reunification took place, 1867 and 1871, Europe had already achieved a milestone. Now they could claim that they had, at least Germans, Italians, French, the Dutch, and even the British had achieved some level of modern state building. Their structure of the state was at least not lacking in the requisite composites, the representative government, especially the restriction of the king's power. Though in Germany and Italy it came a little later, but especially in Britain. So we see a succession of events taking place, and then the process of integration is continuing. And by the time the Europe had seen the last war, which they claim was hopefully the last in global war, world war, after the end of Second World War, they had come to realize that, well, neither religion nor artificially removing the diversity nor suppressing religion, sects, languages, or for that matter even the rights of LGBTs, which came later, but this realization was coming along. They learned the lesson from history that you can't bring about integration through war, through suppressions, through using the state apparatuses against the people. And a concept of modern welfare, representative, responsible state emerged. Though it is not perfect yet, but during the last 70 years, Europe has not seen any major war, except for the Balkans, which were a different phenomena. So Europe has at least achieved a certain degree of integration within the states and across the Europe, the modern Europe. But that doesn't mean integration means assimilation or irreversible process of self-determination. I mean, the ultimate cradle of democracy, Britain itself, is now having to face maybe another secession by Scotland after the Brexit. Belgium, for the so many years, is now grappling with the question of whether to give Flanders and France their separate status. In the Basque, there is a war going on against the Spanish government. But by and large, Europeans have learned that you cannot suppress identities which are historical, which are logical, which are productive, which are positive. And every right of self-determination is not a threat to the society or the state, because they had fought the wars, two wars, Second World War, First World War, and lost millions of people. So now, I'm discussing Europe, because Europe has had the history where different communities, equally divided, equally combatant, equally hostile in terms of their religion and their sects and their ideas, ideologies. Unfortunately, as we are having now here in Pakistan or in this region, or maybe in the Muslim world, we are divided. Now, the only difference is that they have evolved the state in such a way as to resolve the conflicts, at least help resolve the conflicts, through constitutional, societal, economic, policy initiatives. They are trying to somehow address to the complexities of the diversities, of the conflicts. On the contrary, the state that we are living in either doesn't have the will or the capacity to resolve conflicts, or I would say, on the contrary, it is actually enhancing, it is actually feeding. Because if you look at the constitutional journey during the last 70 years that we have had, you will see at no point of time the state was objectively, actively involved in the resolution. State was playing its role more like a catalyst, is trying to ignite, aggravate, and ultimately bring about bring itself to a point where it had to use so-called legitimately draconian laws and oppressive instruments. We saw that during the 50s in dealing with this Ahmadi question. We saw later on during the dictatorial regimes, during Ziaul-Haq, and even before that in 1970, when they refused to even accept the majoritarian principle on which the democracy is based. They let go half the country, but they won't change. And even now you see, what are we crying for? What are we fighting for? What are we struggling for? We just want a basic norm of democracy to prevail. Now you see, when I say democracy, I mean a certain level of predictability or certainty to the institutions to play their role as is envisaged in terms of the constitution. Now, if I have to go to the court to resolve a civil dispute, it takes decades. If I have to go against the state or certain instrument of state, I put myself into a land of unknown, whether I'll be able to actually get somebody out of the illegal confinement, or I'll help somebody recover his member of the family by filing a writ of habeas corpus. Because now the situation has become so intractable, so difficult, that you can't even predict that if I go to a certain state institution, I can expect any relief from that. So in this desperate situation, when we talk about the integration, and when we talk about the historical existential entities which have their roots back into thousands of years old civilization, coming from Mehrgarh and Mohenjo-daro, there are people still here who can claim back their, who can trace back their roots to those times. Now, I do not say that Pakistan is an anomaly, Pakistan is the only country in the world. You have recently seen in America, the race relations is still a smoldering, is a tinderbox, in fact. During the last 300 years, Americans have been trying to somehow resolve this race relations issue. And of course, when we talk about race relations, it has its extensions into other areas, its political ramifications, its economic, then protectionist, nationalist policies and all that. So we saw how brittle, how fragile is the democracy when it comes to grappling with the issues for which the state has failed to resolve the basic conflicts due to political or some powerful interest groups capture. You saw in last 3-4 years, America was captured by a particular neocon, nationalist, populist mindset. So, again coming back to the role of state, my humble submission is that when we talk about the issues which are directly, which impinge on the ways and means to at least coalesce, let alone integrate or create cohesive, a sense of cohesiveness, we need to first of all fix the state structures. Unless the state structures are fixed, you can never imagine, because whether you agree or not, state is the most novel and the most, I think, very special kind of invention which the human being, human civilization has somehow managed to bring about. There's no invention in the world as great maybe as the creation of state. Because state is the ultimate link or the ultimate fallback upon mechanism that modernity provides you. So you are the creature of the state, and yet you are the creator of the states. You are the contracting party to the state. You have so many relationships with the state. So beyond that, we cannot imagine working out relations with each other purely on bonhomie or goodwill or whatever you call it. No, it's not possible. Maybe it's a mystical desire. Maybe you divine it, but you can't. So I would again go back to the same question, whether integration is possible given the widening differences between the communities that, again I would say, have been created, not addressed. In fact, they have been created and further widened by those who have captured the state. Now there is no unity among us. There is no unity of thought. There is no unity of objectivity. There is no unity of even basic consensus that we can run this country at least through basic norms of democracy. There are people who will take exception to your even demand for democracy. They would try to somehow dilute it, creating some divine reasons why this country needs certain powerful forces to still exercise their influence, why politicians have failed to perform, since politicians are not capable enough, since they are corrupt. So there is a huge, powerful block of interests. And unfortunately, that interest is not some abstract, a kind of group who is well-wisher. No, they are those who have actually captured our economy. All the industrialist lobbies, all the builders, you will see, all the powerful feudals, tribals, they have consensus that even if there is no democracy, they are fine. The first thing that a dictator does is to call for these particular groups and first of all give them assurance that don't worry, we'll take care of you. So they have a kind of permanent alignment with them. On the other hand, the majority of poor people, masses, those who are disenfranchised, disinherited, dispossessed, they have not been left with any political representation in the name of war against terror. अभी वो गिलगित के हमारे भाई बता रहे थे कि जी मुझको एक इनोसेंट किस्म की बात उनकी जो थी उस पर उन्होंने उसको एटीएम में डाल दिया. आई एम अ लॉयर, आई कम अक्रॉस एवरी डे, हर केस में अब तो एक 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 तरह का एक ये एक एसओपी बन गया है कि किसी को भी अगर आपको फिक्स करना है, कोई भी किसी भी जुर्म में हो, उसमें आप लगा दें एटीए का कानून भी. उस बेचारे को फिर बेल भी नहीं मिलेगी, वो धक्के खाता फिरेगा और गया। तो एक तरफ ये कन्फ्लिक्ट पैदा होते हैं जो ये पैदा करते हैं थ्रू देयर फॉरेन पॉलिसी, थ्रू देयर इंटरनल पॉलिसीज, वो दे गिव बर्थ टू द कन्फ्लिक्ट्स एंड देन दे नर्चर देम एंड देन दे सीक एक्सक्यूजेस टू ब्रिंग अबाउट दीज ड्रैकोनियन लॉज। तो अब आपका जो प्रोटेस्ट का कल्चर है वो भी बहुत अंडर स्ट्रेन है, आप प्रोटेस्ट भी नहीं कर सकते। कभी वो आपको ब्लैस्फेमी में अंदर कर देते हैं, कभी आपको वो एंटी स्टेट उसमें कोई बात करते हैं। आप अगर लॉ पढ़ें तो मैं समझता हूँ अगर एक पत्थर भी मैंने मार दिया और वो गलती से किसी ट्रैफिक सिग्नल की लाइट को लग गया तो मैं गया, वो डाल देंगे मुझको टेररिज्म के उसमें, बिकॉज टेररिज्म की डेफिनेशन इतनी वाइड है कि यू कांट इमेजिन, यू कैन फिट इन एनी थिंग इन टू दैट। तो जब स्टेट ने जो अपनी जो लीगल फ्रेमवर्क हैज़ बीन क्रिएटेड नॉट टू लिबरेट, नॉट टू प्रोटेक्ट राइट्स एंड लिबर्टीज, बट टू फर्दर इंस्लेव, फर्दर फिक्स द पॉपुलेशन द पीपल, तो फिर आप बताएं कि वो किस तरीके से आपको ये इंटीग्रेशन की जो आपकी जो ये विश है उसको पूरा करने देंगे। सो नाउ दिस वॉज द डार्कर साइड दैट आई ट्राई टू प्रोटेक्ट एंड आई हैड टू। नाउ The brighter side is that fortunately or unfortunately, the entire world is passing through this process. यहाँ पे जो diversity का issue है वो अभी तक basic issue है कि nationalities को उनके rights नहीं मिल रहे, minorities को protection नहीं मिल रही, और जहाँ पे inequities बढ़ती जा रही हैं वहाँ पे कुछ ज़्यादा, क्योंकि वो आगे हैं हमसे बहुत ज़्यादा, तो उनके LGBTs के मसले हैं, वहाँ पे भी इनिक्विटीज़ के मसले हैं, वहाँ पे क्लाइमेट के इश्यूज़ को बहुत ज़्यादा अहमियत दे रहे हैं, उस पर भी सोसाइटीज़ डिवाइड हो चुकी हैं। सो आई थिंक डिवर्सिटी इज़ नॉट रॉन्ग, डिफरेंस इज नॉट रॉन्ग, रादर डिफरेंस इज रिक्वायर्ड, डिफरेंस इज प्रोडक्टिव पॉजिटिव इफ वी यूज इज एज अ कैटलिस्ट टू गो फर्दर। वहाँ पे 4 साल में वो समझ गए कि ट्रंप जो है वो तबाह कर देगा इस मुल्क को, हम 70 साल में भी नहीं समझ सके, लेकिन अब सवाल ये है कि हम कौन हैं वहाँ पे। हम तो एक आम आदमी भी है जो वोट दे के उसको हटा सकता था, यहाँ पे हम 70% भी शामिल नहीं है, क्योंकि यहाँ पे आपकी इलेक्शन भी चोरी हो जाती हैं। सो यू सी your individual self or determination is denied, your social, your cultural, your historical identities are denied, your right to select your rulers is denied. Now in this situation we have to be a little more than what we call ourselves, that is wishful. We cannot be wishful, we have to be very realistic. Integration is a far cry. First we have to learn, first of all, and we have to explore how to create a kind of, create to nahi kahunga, how to further stress upon the discourse to first of all somehow make the democratic dispensation even its barest form possible. बिकॉज आपके पास कोई टूल तो हो, आपको वो गन नहीं उठाने देंगे क्योंकि आपको तो एक पत्थर मारने की भी इजाज़त नहीं है। तो अब एक तरफ आप ये भी नहीं कर सकते हो और फिर आपके पास कोई बेसिक टूल भी नहीं है किसी को भी, वो अब मैं जो तकरीर कर रहा हूँ मुझके किसी आउट ऑफ कंटेक्स्ट मुझको उठा के बिल्कुल डाल सकते हैं अंदर वो। बिकॉज इन दिस काइंड ऑफ रेस्ट्रिक्टिव सोसाइटीज एंड वेरी ऑपरेसिव स्टेट्स we have to think very practically. So my humble submission is ke bengali sahab jaise log baithe hue hain yahan pe jinhone baluchistan mein bhi kaam karke dekha hai, last ek conference thi usme chief minister baluchistan ne publicly speech mein kaha ki mujhko nahi pata ke chinese wahan pe kya kar rahe hain, because I was not allowed even to go to those places where they used to work. So you see, now this is the reality. अनफॉर्चुनेटली हमारी पिछली दो नस्लें इस रोमांस में हमने गवा दी कि शायद वो जो 19th सेंचुरी नेशनलिज्म थी हमारी, वननेस जो है, सिंधी जो है वो प्योर सिंधी और जिस तरह वो किसी ज़माने में होता था, आई थिंक वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू गो देयर नाउ. वी शुड नॉट गो देयर नाउ. वी हैव टू एक्सेप्ट डिवर्सिटी, वी हैव टू एक्सेप्ट कलेक्टिविटी, वी हैव टू एक्सेप्ट ईच अदर, बिकॉज दिस वी कैन नॉट डिनाई द रियलिटी. नाउ इट डजेंट मीन दैट यू गिव इन, इट डजेंट मीन दैट यू सरेंडर योर पोलिटिकल, योर सिविल, योर हिस्टोरिकल राइट्स. Rather, you should create a coalition, because everybody is afraid, everybody is denied, everybody is deprived. There's a huge reservoir of people who can be tapped into and bring together if we somehow manage to understand that diversity, the kind of diversity we are trying to delegitimize, is not possible. We are living in Karachi. Karachi is part of Sindh, but it is not a Sindhi city. We have to accept it. Everybody is living here, and we are all, there are so many commonalities among us. Maybe we are not speaking the same language, but there are lots of commonalities. Let's explore those. When we go into this stream, we leave so many streams and ultimately end up being isolated. So we have to set our priorities straight. We have to understand the dynamics. We have to understand the world where we are in a drift. ये सिर्फ पाकिस्तान की बात नहीं है. This entire globe is now in a drift because middle class पैदा हुआ है. About more than 1000 million middle class पैदा हुआ है. वो middle class चुप करके नहीं बैठेगा, वो लड़ता रहेगा, मजीद मांगेगा. जो नीचे बैठा हुआ है वो ऊपर आएगा. World is in a drift. China is, you know, churning out middle classes. India is churning out middle classes. Hamara process reverse mein ja raha hai. So there are societal conflicts as well. Hamara middle class tabah barbaad ho ja raha hai. Hamara agrarian society breakdown ho gayi hai. Wahan pe pani nahi hai. Wahan pe physical infrastructure khatam hota ja raha hai. Wahan public investment nahi ho rahi. Banks privatized hone ki wajah se humko wahan pe koi jo hai capital investment nahi kar sakte hum. तो ये सारे जो भी इश्यूज हैं इनको समझने की ज़रूरत है. दे विल ऑल कम इन द वे ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन. सो माय हम्बल सबमिशन इज दैट इट वुड बी फार मोर बेटर दैट इंस्टेड ऑफ एक्सपेंडिंग अवर होराइजन एंड सीकिंग अवर रूट्स इनटू द इंडस सिविलाइजेशन व्हिच ऑफ कोर्स आर देयर इवन इफ वी डोंट ट्राई टू सीक, बट वी हैव टू लिंक दैट aspiration to the reality which is staring in our face. Because civilizational or cultural or these romantic objects require a certain level of stability, affluence, development, and above all congruity. There is so much conflict among us. We are not yet on one page. We are all here, but we are all split, all divided, atomized. So in Pakistan, as long as the state is not brought into some kind of democratic mode, as long as we middle class do not discharge our historical role as the pushers of, or the what you call the pushers of the wheel of history as they did in Europe, and if we remain divided to our parochial and our own romantic hankering after past, I think we are going to miss yet another bus. So this is a modern world. We have to see it in the eyes and see what is there for us, and let's not shirk, let's not just run away from it. We have to take it as it comes, and I am very optimistic. There are millions of youngsters who are quite capable. I see lots of barristers, Ravi Panjwani jaise, they are doing wonders. They are real civil rights lawyers, fighters, and we will give them a run for their money even. So we have to first of all create a consensual atmosphere, an an area of commonality. We should explore where we can all meet, and then we seek diversity, not for the sake of alienating each other, but for the sake of creating a commonality and to respect each other and ultimately to love each other. Switzerland mein, those communities are living, whose countries were fighting during First World War and Second World War, but they did not even have one casualty in Switzerland. Only because the state, the confederal state, had given each community. French bhi rehte hain wahan pe, Italians bhi rehte hain wahan pe, Germans bhi rehte hain wahan pe, unke apne bhi rehte hain. They all live for centuries without any tension, because it is the most, I think, functional confederation or federation. Jahan pe gali ka naam tabdil karne ke liye bhi wo referendum karwate hain local level pe, ki log kya kehte hain ki gali ka naam change hona chahiye. So this kind of participatory culture will ultimately bring about integration, and ultimately the vehicle is the state. So we have to first see what kind of a state we want, and if there is something missing in this state, then we make sure that the missing links are substituted, and a composite, organic, workable state can be made possible. Thank you very much.